Hey everyone, today we're going to walk through the essential steps of instrument reprocessing in your dental practice. Proper reprocessing is crucial for ensuring patient safety and maintaining high standards of infection control. We'll cover four main areas: receive and decontaminate, clean, inspect and package, and sterilize and store. Number one, receive and decontaminate. The first step in the reprocessing cycle is to have an area to receive the dirty, reusable dental instruments and decontaminate them. When you receive the instruments after a procedure, it's essential to handle them carefully to prevent injury and minimize contamination. Place the used instruments in a designated container for transportation to the decontamination area. This container should be leak-proof with labels of biohazard symbols, and in the decontamination area, you're going to immediately begin the process of removing gross debris and organic material. This step often involves using an enzymatic spray or solution to pre-soak the instruments, which helps break down blood and other organic matter. This makes the cleaning process more effective and reduces the risk of biofilm formation. Number two, clean. After decontamination, the next step is cleaning. Cleaning is a critical phase where you physically remove all residual matter from the instruments. Use ultrasonic cleaners, washer or disinfectors, or manual scrubbing with detergents designed for medical instruments. The key here is to ensure that every surface of the instrument is thoroughly cleaned. Ultrasonic cleaners are especially useful because they use sound waves to create microscopic bubbles that dislodge debris from those hard-to-reach areas. Always try to limit the need to manually scrub instruments in order to decrease the opportunity for percutaneous injuries. And remember, an unclean instrument should not be sterilized. Number three, inspect and package. During the inspection step, carefully examine each instrument for any signs of damage, wear, or remaining debris. And instruments with visible damage or persistent contamination should be removed from service and either repaired or disposed of appropriately. After inspection and ensuring the instruments have fully dried, package the instruments for sterilization. Packaging materials should be chosen based on the type of sterilization process you will use. Typically, you'll be using sterilization pouches or wraps that allow the sterilant to penetrate while maintaining the sterility of the contents after the process. Now, an essential component of the packaging process is the use of chemical indicators. For packs that are wrapped, indicators are placed inside the packaging and on the outside of the package. These will change colors when exposed to specific sterilization conditions. For pouches, both the external and internal indicators are built into the design and can be seen from the plastic side of the pouch. These chemical indicators provide a visual confirmation that the package or pouch has been processed and that the sterilization cycle has met all necessary parameters. In addition, proper labeling of each package is crucial for tracking and ensuring correct handling post-sterilization. Before the item goes into the sterilizer, it should be labeled with the sterilizer being used. So for example, autoclave A. Then it should have the date, the load number of the day, and the initials of the person packaging the items. Number four, sterilize and store. The sterilization step allows all instruments to be free from any viable microorganisms. And it's important to properly store these instruments to help ensure they stay sterile until they're used again. Place the packaged instruments into the sterilizer following the manufacturer's instructions for load configuration and cycle parameters. Now, some of the most common methods of sterilization in the dental practices are typically steam sterilization or autoclaving, dry heat sterilization, and chemical vapor sterilization. And with each method, there are specific guidelines that must be adhered to in order to achieve effective sterilization. So it's important to monitor each sterilization cycle with mechanical, chemical, and biological indicators, often called spore testing. This is to ensure that the process is working correctly. Mechanical indicators involve checking the sterilizer's cycle parameters. Chemical indicators change color when exposed to the conditions and making sure they are met. And biological indicators involve using spore tests to verify the killing of microorganisms. After sterilization, store the instruments in a clean and dry area designated for sterile instruments. It's essential to maintain the integrity of the packaging until the instruments are ready for use. And this means handling them with clean hands or gloves and ensuring they are not exposed to contaminants or excessive moisture. Organize your sterile storage area in a way that allows for easy access and rotation of stock, allowing that first in, first out principle to ensure older packages are used before newer ones. By following these detailed steps, receive and decontaminate, clean, inspect and package, and sterilize and store, you'll ensure that your instruments are properly reprocessed, reducing the risk of infection and safeguarding the health of your team members and your patients. Be sure to check out henryschein.com and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this.